So find in Word is very powerful. We have a separate video for these options and format options. But then there is a whole ball game of very powerful search methodology, which is called wildcards, and that's what we are going to see today. By the way, how do you get to this quickly? Press Ctrl H, which is replace, and now click on find or press Alt D. So let's take an example first. I have a lot of text here. I have slide number followed by some details. Okay, so I just want the slide numbers to be selected so that I can copy paste them somewhere else. If I go to search and search for the word slide and I say find all actually means find in main document. But this is not what I want. I want slide 1, slide 2, slide 34, all of them to be selected, not this word slide. Now that becomes tricky. And that's when wildcard comes into picture. So what is it going to find right now? Just the word slide. No, I want a space. And then I want to define what comes after this space. Now I know some numbers are going to come after this, but what I don't know is whether it is 1 digit, 2 digits, or 3 digits, 4 digits. No problem. And that's where we go to special. So it's saying which characters are we looking for in any order? Yes, but the range we know. So what is the range? These are numbers, so they have to be between 0 and 9. Okay. And how many numbers are going to come one after another? Maybe 1, maybe 2, maybe 4. I don't know. So then we have number of occurrences, which is in curly braces. Now you have to say starting with how many and ending with how many. So 1, fine. And how many upper limit? We don't have an upper limit. Leave it blank. And now you will notice main document, which is like find all. I could actually find all of them. And in one click now I can copy them, go somewhere else and paste them. That is the power of wildcard. Now let's take another example. Let's say I only want to copy the names. Now names means what? I have to find a pattern. So what pattern? Wildcard, yes. Find, yes. Special and characters in range. We are talking about A to Z. But this is not going to work because these are lowercase characters. We want to start with the uppercase character. Okay, so let's put this. I'm going to say first should be uppercase. So we say A to Z uppercase, followed by lowercase. Now let's see what happens. Now it does select it, but then it only selects one lowercase character. We know what to do here. So curly brace, start with 1, but it can be many more. We don't want to give an upper limit. And now I have selected all the names. Now let's do one more interesting thing. This whole thing is a component. Just put it in brackets. What are we interested in? The number. So again, that's a second component. So I'm going to put brackets 0 to 9. We have done this before. Any number of occurrences. Very good. So now it has found everything. So what is the big deal? What have we achieved? So now notice when I go to replace, I also get special things. So it's saying find what expression / n. N means 1, 2, 3, first expression, second expression, third expression. So everything in brackets is an expression. This is the first one, this is the second one. So now I'm saying put the second one first, then put a space, and now we say replace all. Notice what happened beautifully. It just reversed them. Isn't that powerful? Maybe it's a good time to subscribe at this point. So let's take another interesting example. I have a city followed by 2 numbers. Now what we are really going to look for is 3 components. 1 number followed by what? I don't even know what this is. It's a good idea to enable these hidden characters. Dot means space, by the way. How do I know what means what? This means paragraph mark. You don't have to guess. If you go to file options display, it actually shows you how each one of them looks. So what am I looking for now? A single digit followed by space, followed by any uppercase character. And by now, you know exactly what to write. And I want a number from 0 to 9, followed by a space, and followed by a character. So it's important to put them as expressions. So this is the first expression, and then this is the second expression. Okay, so now what do I want here? I want first segment or first expression. Then I want caret sign P, which means paragraph mark, and then the second expression. And all that I have to do is say replace all. And that's how I split it into 2 rows. Amazing stuff. Now let's take another example. I have this data and I want to split the name and the number. And want to create a table. Generally what will happen, I will go to insert text, convert text to table. But here, what do I give? If I put space, wherever there is space, extra columns will get created. So I can't use paragraph. I can't say other and say space because none of them is going to work. This is not what I want. So what I want really is to use tab as the character. If you enable hidden characters, all of them are spaces. So this one, I want as tab. In find, what am I looking for? First component, I'm looking for a space, right? So I'm looking for space. Expression one and expression two, I'm looking for one or more numbers. We already know how to do that. Any number of digits. Here we want to put tab character, right? So where is tab character? This one. Well, caret sign T. And then we just want to change this to second expression. And now we say replace all. Now I can go to insert table, convert text to table. This time it automatically understood that these are tabs. And now I get a perfect table. Now here is another very interesting example. I have many records, but they have just come one next to another. This happens very often when we copy paste from web page or somewhere. Where do I really want the character? Before any number, which is followed by space and dot. Okay, we know the pattern matching now. How many times this should come? Right now it is single digit, but let's assume it will be multiple digits after 10. And this whole thing is space. And then there is dot. And this whole component is our first component, so to say. So now all that I have to do is first check whether this find in works. It is correctly doing it. So now what do I want to do? Replace with what? I want to put the paragraph mark character. And then put whatever is there in the first expression. We are already well versed with this. So click outside so that nothing is there. Make sure it is all. And then say replace all. Yes, we did get one extra enter key above, but that's okay. We can just delete it. Here is a little more complex looking example, but the concepts are exactly same. I've got some data copy pasted from a web page. These are addresses of some banks. So each one of them has many, many different things, but all I am interested in is the address part. There is address, space, colon, and then there is a whole lot of stuff there. God knows how many characters, how many of them are numbers, commas. There is no guaranteed thing. So we say first component will be address, space, colon, and then whatever is there, we want everything to come. But then at the end, what is there? There is paragraph mark. Now paragraph mark we know is caret sign P, but there is a problem. When I try to do this, it says, sorry, caret sign P is not a special character when wildcard is on. So we have to do a workaround. So we have to do it in two steps. I'm just going to cut this and keep it in memory. But before we do this wildcard stuff, we know that there are lots of paragraph marks here. So all those paragraph marks we'll first search for and then convert them to some intermediate character. It's nothing special, so I'm going to look for paragraph mark and replace it with some character which I know is not used anywhere. So tilde sign or anything else you can use. Say simple replace all. Now it looks very confusing, doesn't matter. So now we go to wildcard mode. We don't need this any longer. And instead of this, I'm going to put tilde. When I say search, notice what it's going to do. Find in main document. It found all the addresses. So I can just copy them. Go to a new document and paste all addresses. Of course, the original one I have spoiled. So before I do anything else, I'll bring it back to the previous state using undo. Unbelievable stuff happening in Word. You'll be surprised to know this is available for at least 20 years, if not more. That is the power of Word wildcard search. For those who are technical, you know what this is called. It's called regular expressions. But even before that, 20, 25 years, Word has been offering this extremely powerful feature. So that's it for now. I have no doubt that you found this useful. And I also am confident that you will find value in subscribing to my channel. Oh, I have Word tables best practices video. Have a look at that as well. So that's it for now. Thank you.